Hello, everyone. DataTherm is going to walk you through an important announcement from the Apple App Store that will affect your organization's apps and how it's seen publicly to your users who download the app and also to privacy advocates, legal firms, and compliance bodies. So this is an important one to pay attention to because there's some subtleties that we need to go through. With that, let's go ahead and get started. So on December 8th and after 2020, every time you submit an app to the App Store, either a new one or update your existing apps, your developers or your product managers or whoever has access to developer.apple.com will be required to fill out a questionnaire, a form, if you will, about the data you collect in your app and who that is shared with and where, essentially. Now, this was actually announced on November 5th, 2020, and the process starts on December 8th, 2020. And so what Apple and the whole community is trying to do is give broader transparency to the end user who's downloading or potentially downloading these apps from the App Store of what data of theirs will be taken by your app and if you're going to use it for internal purposes or you're going to share it with third parties. So it's actually great transparency if you're a user of apps. You have to really love it, especially with all the privacy stuff around the globe with GDPR, CCPA, and others. However, if you're not paying close enough attention for your organization, you could be set up to fail accidentally by this new request. And it could be a trap, not a direct on-purpose trap by Apple and our good friends in Cupertino, but a blind trap. And that's what I'm going to talk about over the next 15 minutes. So when you fill out this questionnaire from Apple during the App Store submission process, your organization is probably going to have owners of that account, usually, again, product managers or developers. Whatever they say that they're collecting in the app is going on public record. It's going to be publicly viewed by everyone. That's the transparency part. That's pretty cool. But the opposite is that if they're incorrect, if they're underreporting, then that is a very bad situation, because if you're underreporting the data you're collecting, either why you're collecting it or who you're sharing it with, you could be exposing the entire company to lots of legal litigation, a lot of issues with privacy advocates and everything in between. So in my opinion, you're on notice by Apple, not just on the record for legal data collection procedures. So this is a short list of the types of questions they're going to ask you if you're collecting or not. And when you fill out this questionnaire, we'll go through it in just a second. You're going to be asked who you're sharing it with anyone. Now, what happens if you underreport anything from the previous list? So you go through here and through the best of your ability, you kind of answer the questions, but you underreport. Well, if you underreport, the people who use your applications, the citizens of Earth, they're not going to be very happy and they might find alternatives. But to be honest, that's not going to be a big deal for you, right? You know, there's not an A for A equivalent of your app. And so while they might be upset and they might be grumpy, there's really no alternative they're going to go to, because every app is unique in some special way. What really is the problem that has a lot more dollar signs next to it is GDPR. GDPR can fine you big time, 3% of revenue. For example, in 2020 alone, Google was fined 50 million euros in 1 year for their GDPR issues. And you can see other companies are all in the very large millions. So this could be a lot of money. Now, you should be pushing back a little bit on me saying, listen, we're not Google. So come on, like with these big numbers, we get it, but we're not Google. We don't expect to have these fines. And you're probably right, but the fines might be as small as 150,000. $150,000 for most organizations is not a lot of money, but I want you to think about your security budget and how much you spend on mobile or mobile security and mobile privacy. This might be a third of your budget you're spending on your mobile apps, half the budget, more than the budget, honestly, depending on how many apps you have. So the point is here is whether it's a GDPR fine or an FTC fine, you just don't want to be fined. You're going to lose money, whether it's a small amount of money into hundreds of thousands or a large amount of money, 3% of revenue. You want to stay away from it in any shape, way, or form. And in 2020 in California, Prop 24 was passed, which is also more privacy protection for end users of your application that are in the state of California. So the privacy train is alive and well, and it's going to hit you from all directions. Again, users of your app who are finding an alternative is not going to be a big deal, but these fines will be unless you disclose actually what you're doing technically and accurately. So let's pause here for a second and say, okay, what's the big deal? So the big deal isn't, hey, that you're collecting an email address and you're using it for your app's functionality. I'm not worried about that. What I'm worried about is when your developers, rightfully so, use third-party code, like open source software and commercial SDKs, everyone uses it. That's how you write mobile apps. But when they don't know that the free software they're getting is not being paid for by dollars, but by data, these analytics SDKs, advertising SDKs, user behavior SDKs, UX SDKs, whatever it is, they're monetizing on data. And it's big business. In fact, Segment, which is one of the more popular ones, was acquired by Twilio in 2020 for $3.2 billion. This is $3.2 billion for an up-and-coming company that's a data company on mobile applications and some other applications. So don't get me wrong. While you are sharing your user's device ID, your user's location, your user's whatever, Segment and other companies like it are using that to monetize big time and to be a billion-dollar company instead of taking your dollars itself. So this is a big business. To the point, if you look at this screenshot, this just kind of shows you Segment's market reach. And if you look at the red squares, their market reach right now is about 10 to 15%. 10 to 15% is a small number, and they're still worth $3.2 billion. So the data that you are inadvertently sharing on your app of your users, location, device, is big business. Don't get me wrong. And that's what you must share when you fill out that Apple questionnaire on the iTunes submission process. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at what that actually is gonna be. So I'm gonna switch to an actual app that's being submitted on the App Store. So now this is the App Store Connect dashboard that you see in front of you. And this is what your developers will need to fill out. They'll go to App Privacy on the left-hand side, and they'll click on Edit on Data Types. And the first question is straightforward. Are you collecting data from this app? And the answer is yes, most apps do. Then it's gonna ask you what data you're collecting. Now notice it's just asking you. There's no technical verification. This is like SurveyMonkey, if you will. So you can say, hey, I'm collecting the name, email address. Let's say I'm a fintech app. So I'm clicking payment info and done and done. Your product manager, your developer is being honest and saying, okay, this is it. Let's see how fast I can get through this wizard because I got to release this app. I'm going to hit save. So they hit save. And now they have to tell you or tell Apple what they're doing with the data. You can say, hey, I'm using it for the app's functionality, which is probably the correct answer. And if they do know, they might be saying, hey, we're sharing it with third parties or analytics, right? This is my concern for you all. This is why I want to talk to you so urgently. This is it. Once they hit next, this will be published publicly to the App Store. This is where you are on record and you are on notice. So if the product manager or the developer answers incorrectly and underreports, that is now speaking on the behalf of the entire company that this is the data we're disclosing. Notice security doesn't have an account on here. Legal compliance, again, doesn't have an account on here. So if they underreport, any GDPR privacy advocate legal firm can see what you're reporting and see if that's correct or not through technical means. So this is the part where we need to make sure you are disclosing the correct information. So going back to the slides, this is why DataTheorem is gonna hopefully make your life easier. What we're gonna do is give you the answer key. In our product, we already scanned for everything here. We've been doing it for a very long time, so we got you covered here. If your developers or your product managers say, hey, we're collecting email, payment info, and location, and that's about it, we're gonna tell you with this new toolkit called App Store Answers, what you're actually sharing. So the good news is the answers to the questionnaire that Apple is asking you starting on December 8th is already at your fingertips. So we need to make sure the person who's filling out this questionnaire has access to the Datatherm results so they know that, hey, we are collecting the device ID and we're sharing it with Segment, or we're collecting advertising data. You might not know you're collecting this data, and this is where the discrepancy comes up. If you think you're collecting things in green, we'll tell you saying, hey, you're also collecting things in red. At that point, you have two decisions: disclose it correctly, which is fine, or remove that because maybe you don't want to share your user's device ID with a third party. And in the past, you probably didn't really think twice about it, but now you do, because again, it's going to be public record. And either your users are not going to appreciate that, or if you go ahead and report that, if you don't report that, then compliance bodies will come after you. So the good news is, again, the answers are in here in this new toolkit called App Store Answers. So whoever fills out that form on developer.apple.com must be given this information, and we're going to make it very easy for them to have answer for those answers.